Previously on Alan Wake, something I only know is the Dark Presence held my wife captive and used her to make me write a horror story that came true.
I'll bring her back.
Some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story.
Alan?
I saved Alice, then wrote a better ending for the story. But not without a price. I was trapped somewhere in the dark place, a strange zone somewhere beyond our world.
It's not a lake. It's an ocean.
What's going on, everybody? And welcome to part 5 of my blind playthrough for Alan Wake's The Signal. Ooh. So awesome and creepy and... You know, this isn't really what I'd call a scary game, per se. Well, maybe that one part with the dude with the chainsaw. That was kind of terrifying. Bridge? Wait. What, did they just spawn this? Is that what that did? Can we kick that down? I love that new mechanic. That was an... Oh, yeah, see, look. Doing things manly. Kicking things down. Another bridge? That's kind of... What did that... Did it just do this? Oh. What's happening? Interesting. And you know, I was actually thinking right before... Who's this? Oh, it's Alice. Is that Barry? Wait. Oh, is it a time puzzle? That's what it sounded like. That's cool. I wonder if you get anything for finding all these. These are cool. I really like these. These are very clever. This whole game is clever, which is one of the things I think it really gets me about the game, how clever some of the stuff is. And although the whole game I have been comparing Alan Wake, because the Alan Wake American Nightmare is sort of like Alan Wake 2, it's not really, but you know what I mean, it's the next one they made, but this is like a DLC to this game that they plan to come out with it. That's what most DLC is. A lot of people, you know, nowadays plan DLC differently, but this was planned to be part of the story, which I like. But I was just thinking, just sitting here now and looking at the entire game, like reflecting on it, wait. You know, in hindsight, maybe I shouldn't monologue while I'm about to run up to something. I'm not sure where I'm going. But the point I'm trying to make is actually that this Alan Wake is great. I love the atmosphere and everything, but it is kind of dark and sort of misty. The colors are sort of a certain palette type, if you know what I mean. Okay, we didn't need to jump. See, I overcomplicate things.
Crazy dangerous, Al!
Thanks, Barry. I live on the edge. Danger. Oh, crap. Whoa. Oh, crud. Come on, bring him down. Shit, I should have seen that coming. Finish this guy, because he'll kill us. Dude! Get back! Back, I say. Oh, if only we had pushed him off the edge, that would have been cool. Oh. I love tapping faster to reload your gun. It's a really cool thing. And it's funny that what I was just talking about, like the whole color and the scenery being kind of, you know what I mean? It's like kind of dark, gloomy, and misty. And that fits the atmosphere, but Alan Wake American Nightmare isn't actually like that. It's actually very bright. That's one thing I just realized when I was sitting here getting ready to do this episode. I was like, you know, Alan Wake American Nightmare is actually a lot brighter colored, like more colors to it. And it just reminds me of like Gears of War, the way Gears of War 1 and 2 are. Actually, more like 2 and 3.
Hey, lover. Come here. Ooh. I've got something for you.
Oh.
I could only hope that Alice was all right. I didn't know what happened to her after she left the dark place.
Ah, she's fine. I wouldn't worry about it. Candles? Like, everywhere? That's kind of cool. I like this track, too. It's a nice track. What was that?
Jane? Is that you?
Oh, he doesn't expect us to jump down here, does he? Leap of faith! That was a horrible... Whoa!
Hey, hold that pose. That was a good one.
Like this?
Yeah, but smile a little more. No, that's too much. You want to look mysterious. Maybe a little tough. You know how people go for those dangerous bad boys.
But I'm not dangerous.
Oh, come on. You write about terrible things all the time. People want to think that you're intimately familiar with them. You kill Casey in this book. You need to look a little bit like a murderer. Oh, that's good. Do that again. you're looking handsome.
And dangerous.
You know, I wasn't sure about the beard before, but I was wrong. It looks good on you. Okay, I think we're done.
Great. I want to get out of this suit.
Hey, things are looking up.
Guess danger is sexy.
That was when I was still working, when I felt like a real writer instead of a fraud. It was a good memory. I wished I hadn't seen it.
Why would you wish to not see a good memory? That's kind of funny. That... oh. Whoa. Okay. Oh. Whoa! Oh. Oh, we're in our house, in our apartment. Oh. Gosh, last time we were here, some crazy stuff went down. I'll take those. That sounds awful, that breathing. Where's the clock? I'm gonna choose the wrong door, I know. I think this is the door to go out. Okay, well, I don't have much of a choice. Oh, there we go. Nice. I might just find them all, who knows. It sounds awfully scary. Whoa. Oh. I wonder which way they want us to go.
Alan, you made it. This area of the dark place is calmer, at least for the time being. We can talk here, but we don't have much time.
Zane, how do I get out of here?
That's what you face. That's you, even as we speak.
Darkness. Darkness coming! Swept him away. Lost. He knew. He knew! He couldn't hold on. He knew there was no way out.
Oh. No, I'm right here,
oh,
Zane.
I'm going wrong.
That's not me, it's just...
wrong.
I don't know, an echo, a hallucination. The dark presence.
No. The Dark Presence is not responsible for this. You are making this happen. You're trapped in your own nightmares. You are fighting yourself.
Wake didn't understand it. He would never make it. He would never wake up. He'd get swallowed up in the rising tide of darkness. It was coming. It was coming.
Shut up!
No, Alan, you must.
Swept away by the gathering insanity. Zane was gone. Wake could feel the pressure, gnawing at his mind. The darkness wasn't so bad. It was in him. He felt it. He knew the voice spoke the truth. It was just too hard to think. He can't. Couldn't make sense of it. Couldn't. He wanted to go with the flow. Stop thinking and just let go.
No, I don't think so. Oh. Oh, the room's blocked off now. What's going on here? Oh, crap. Oh, God. Someone stop the TV. The TV's gone mad. Jesus, I'm getting slammed. Flare? Flare. What was that? Pick up hunting rifle? Pick it up. Do I have to shoot this thing? Oh, okay. Okay, destroy the TVs. That's an objective. Huh. Well, that was crazy. Huh. I don't think I want to go down there. That doesn't look like somewhere I want to go. Oh. Hunt the TVs down! Jesus. Take the shotgun ammo. I'm low on health, uh-oh. Can I... Oh my god, what a sucker punch. Gosh, alright. Let's try that again. Can we... no? That'd be too easy. Alright, go for the... This hit me last time. Now this is gonna hit me this time. How would you get both? I wonder if they just intend you to dodge. I've never quite figured that out with these inanimate objects that can attack me. Oh, is that a Taken? Oh, no. Crap. Well, this is what we have all our batteries for. Oh, come on! Flare. That is just not right. Uh-oh. Not good. No. Oh, crap. Dodge, 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 dodge. Oh, that was a terrible dodge. He, like, turned around and looked him in the face. What are these? Did he just come out of the wall? Come on, man. That's not right. Everything he saw was a twisted memory. I think I just got to use light. Crud. Thank God that guy walked into my flashlight, right? No one ever said the Taken were intelligent. I'm pretty sure, actually, they said quite the opposite. Oh, the TV's, like, moving. This is, like, a mechanic they added in now. Come on. Do I have a flare gun? I think now would be a good time to use a flare gun. Eat this. Yeah. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Turn. Turn, wake. You know, I don't understand why we just don't wear, like, the Christmas lights that Barry does. Like, that's legitimately a good idea. Like, get some LED Christmas lights, strap them around our body like Rambo. That is such a good idea. I'm running out of shots. Uh-oh. Crap, 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 crap. Okay, we need another flare gun here. Jesus. Kill the TV! Yeah. Oh. One TV left? No TV shall survive. Oh, we're out on the dock. That's crazy that it'd be here of all places. Oh. Ho. Oh. Come on. Come on. Holy crap. Birds! Do I have a flare? I do! Come on, hit the boat! Hit the boat! Hit the boat! Yes! Get the TV! Well, I guess that's the end of Alan Wake's The Signal. That was a bit shorter than I thought it'd actually be. But still not too bad. I mean, that was like, what, at least an hour and a half of gameplay for a little add-on. The add-on wasn't much, and actually I got that when I bought the game, so that was kind of nice. And I know there's one more add-on, so who knows? It's always next year, right? But this was kind of nice. Sometimes it's easier just to keep things short and simple. And what I liked about this is, like, I played Alan Wake so long ago, and then I went ahead and I played Alan Wake American Nightmare. And now it's actually kind of starting to actually connect. I wasn't sure how they connected because I didn't play the DLC. Well, this DLC actually does make a difference. It actually does add good amount of story to the to what happened after. I think like a lot of people were kind of like disappointed with the end of Alan Wake, and this DLC is really meant to be played afterwards, because it's kind of a weird, not really a weird ending, but an unsatisfying ending. And this is kind of good because it continues. It's not over. So now I'm actually really curious to see the other DLC. But that was pretty good. I really liked the some of the things they were doing with, like, well, Barry was fun. You can't go wrong with Barry. All the, I wonder if I, geez, I must have missed at least 4 alarm clocks, which makes me wonder. Yeah, I actually thought that would be a little bit longer than it was, but it still wasn't bad. I'm not, like, complaining or anything. I mean, you know, it didn't cost me anything, and it was fun. It was actually really fun to come back and play some more Alan Wake, because I really enjoyed Alan Wake. I thought it was a really good game that I think kind of got hyped up a lot, and then I think didn't really live up to it. I'm not sure what happened to it with Remedy Games and everything, and any more sequels or DLC. There's still plenty more, like I said. There's another DLC, I think it's The Writer. So, like I said, possibility, you never know. It's always next year. And I think there's actually DLC for Alan Wake American Nightmare. I haven't been on that, too, in a while, so that's actually something I want to check out. But, like I said, this was a lot of fun. I really did enjoy this. Even though this was short, the mechanics with the whole, doing all that stuff with the flashlight, with the words and stuff, that was really interesting. And, just the whole game is, I thought Alan Wake, the whole execution of how the gameplay works is actually pretty good myself. But yeah, this was fun. For a little DLC add-on, I actually really enjoyed this, and I hope you guys did too. The Sudden Stop, written by Alan Wake. Departure, by Alan Wake. Alan Wake's journey through the night will continue. So, that's the end of Alan Wake's The Signal. Like I said, it was good. I had fun with it, and I hope you guys did too. But for now, this is where the story will end. I want to thank you guys for watching, and until next time, I'll catch you later.